So tell me what your names are.
My name is Jessica Norwood.
I'm Matthew Hussle.
And how did you guys meet?
We first met here at the cafe. Matthew came in one day. He was applying for a job, but he sat at the front and ate one of our macro plates. And I thought he was super cute at the time. I think for me it was kind of one of those love at first sight moments. And then eventually he started working here, and things just kind of snowballed after that. So.
Nice. So how long have you been together?
2 years.
Yeah, it's a little over 2 years now.
And how long, so you were working here first. Mm-hmm. How long have you worked here for?
Total about 3 years, but I've been eating here my entire life, so I'm very familiar with even the past servers and things like that and the menu, and I was raised on kikuchi tea and nori rolls and Mexican plates, so my heart's always been here.
Very nice, very nice. So now I know that the owner of this restaurant opened one in Traverse City, mm-hmm. right? How long ago was that, do you know?
Probably about 2 years now. 2 years? Yeah.
And what happened with that?
It's still open, yeah. He's up there pretty much running that. He's also got the raw juice company and the parlor, which is a bar that's also an extension of the home up there that he's running. So which is why it kind of came about that Ferndale was a little too much for him to keep maintaining, and we kind of jumped on that, so.
So yeah, he wanted to sell it, mm-hmm. right? And then how did you end up taking over? Were you worried about it closing, or?
Yeah, I think, do you
want to
answer that?
Initially the restaurant was running fine, everything was great. We wanted to move on with our own ventures after gaining experience here, running a restaurant, building menus, things like that, so we wanted to try it on our own. Once that word got to our owner, after a lot of thinking about the situation, he had to decide that he couldn't carry on the restaurant without us. So that resulted in the place going up for sale.
Okay.
Once that went up for sale, all the customers, just kind of flipped their wig over that and wanted to help out any way they could. One of our longtime customers, Bill Blondie, suggested to Jessica to go into business together to continue it basically just the way it is. We were fortunate enough to be able to keep the own name, the same recipes, all of that, so.
Very cool. Yeah, I believe when he was selling it, he wanted to keep the integrity or the history of it, right? Going.
Yeah, we didn't want this to be a Coney Island or anything like that. originally when we gave our notice that we were thinking of leaving, it never crossed our minds that it would possibly end up being the demise of this place too.
Right.
As I said, I've been here my whole life, and so when the opportunity came up, as he said, for us to jump on it, it really was an exciting opportunity for us.
It's been a 30-year staple for vegetarian food in Ferndale, so it's pretty big to us and the community.
Yeah, we've got about 5 places that vegetarians can go around here, so
right.
To take one of those away would be really sad.
So it's official now, and is today your first day opening back up, or?
No, we've been with limited hours for the past 2 weeks. We're in the middle of retraining staff. We've had some new kitchen staff members, so trying to get everyone up to speed. We'll have our grand opening, grand reopening with the old hours, the 10th,
mm-hmm. right? So next week, we will still be closed Sundays and Tuesdays, but we'll be open Mondays and Wednesdays through Saturdays, 12 to 9. We won't be serving our brunch menu right away because we're still finalizing and tweaking that. But we're really super, super excited and stoked. We've had too many days of not being open, and we're really happy and excited to be back.
So did you ever think that you would own this, having come here all your life and working here for so long? How does this feel?
It feels amazing. This is hands down one of the best experiences of my life, and especially as a little girl, and never in my wildest dreams would I have thought. And I know, I've lost my train of thought. I know when I was applying for the job, I was sitting at that table with my mom, and she asked Jason, the old owner, if they were hiring at all, and he said, yeah, and I remember having that moment, and he said, oh, come on in for an interview, and after he left, I looked at my mom and said, I will quit any job I ever have to work here. Just to be a waitress for a few nights a week was more than anything I could ever ask for. So to now to be in this position, it really is my heart and my soul and my dream, and I couldn't be happier. So.
Nice. So what's your favorite dish? What do you recommend to people?
Oh, geez. It depends on the day of the week, time of season. My whole life growing up, of course, it was the Mexican plate. It's a big plate of nachos, which is super awesome. The nori rolls are really great too. We have a house-made tahini dressing. I mean, other than that, I just think a better question is, what don't I like? And even that, I don't even think there's anything. Tacos are really great. I'm really on kind of a taco kick right now. So our taco specials that we're doing every week, I think, are going to be a really good inspiration point for us.
Nice. What about you? What do you recommend?
Some of my favorites is more simple. We have a Brussels dish, which is just pan-seared shaved Brussels sprouts with just a Veganate mustard sauce that goes with that, a little salt and pepper, so garlic. That and the mackerel plate, the first dish I had here, is still my favorite. It's just, very simple, very straightforward, healthy food, so.
Very nice. Is there anything else that people should know about you guys or about this place, or?
I think I would just love to spread the word that we're still open, you know, because a lot of times the home has gone through some changing of hours, and, you know, the old owner might have closed for the winter and stuff like that. So a lot of our clientele doesn't know the fact that we're still here and we're still happy to be here and happy to serve. So just getting the word out that, you know, the grand opening is next week. We want everyone to come. You know, we are very vegan-minded as well and vegetarian-minded. So anyone who's got those certain type of dietary restrictions or gluten-free, you know, we are definitely the place for them as well. As well as people just looking for a change in their diet or just good, awesome food without all the grease and the fat and all that stuff that you get elsewhere. So I would definitely invite people to come check us out and let us know what they think.